Pre-analysis lecture 9 on open and closed sets by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MVS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar. So, before going to discuss open and closed sets, so I want to discuss some definition. So, interior point of a set. Interior point of a set. Okay. So, what is interior point of a set? Let S be a subset of subset R equal to R. A point P is said to be interior point of S if there exists at least one neighborhood of P entirely containing in S. See what I am doing here. This is my real number. This is S. S I am taking set to subset of R. I am taking P is a point. So P, I am taking that P. So P is this point. So, I am taking this point here, this neighborhood, I am taking, this neighborhood does not entirely contain this set. That means, this point is not interior point of. If I take here, so that point, this point, if I take this point, this neighborhood of this point, which is not entirely contain this set. So therefore, this is also not interior point of this. If I take this also, it is not interior point of this. That means, this are the border point. If I take here, so I am taking some point. So interior point of this is, which is entirely contained in this set. That's why this is an interior point of S. Right? So simple, you can observe here. See, I am taking here, this is a real number. So, this is real number I am taking here. This is my set. S is my set. If I take a point, this is P. A point P is said to be interior point of S. How can we say that? There exists at least one neighborhood of P which is entirely contained in the set. What are the neighborhoods of this P? This is one neighborhood, this is one other neighborhood, this is one neighborhood. Okay. These are the neighborhoods of this point. But any neighborhood which is entirely does not contain in the set. That's why this point, this is not interior point of this set. Yeah, if I take here. Okay, if I take this other set, I am taking here, this real number. Suppose I am taking other set here, suppose this is here A, B. Suppose my point, I am taking B, I am verifying about the point B, this is point B only. Whether this point is interior point of the set or not. See, if I take this point here, this point, the B, okay. These are the neighborhoods of, these are the neighborhoods of this point. But this neighborhood does not contain this. This is S, right? So any neighborhood of point, this point, which is does not entirely contain this set, right? Therefore, B is also not interior point of S. Right? Similarly, you can take that here other point A. You can draw the some neighborhoods of A. Okay, this is one neighborhood. Other neighborhood I am drawing. This is other neighborhood. These other neighborhoods. So I am taking that, I am drawing these neighborhoods. See, right side part it has, but left side part does not contain it, right? So which is not entirely this set. That's why this is not interior point of S. If I take other example, this real number, I am taking S. SC, this is S. Okay, I want to take that a point. So here I'm taking this is my point. This is P. So you can draw the neighborhoods of this. Okay, neighborhoods of these points are. This is one neighborhood. I'm drawing. This neighborhood, which is entirely contained in Z. So this neighborhood, which is entirely containing the Z. Okay. If there is possible to find at least one neighborhood which is entirely containing Z, that means neighborhood of this point which is entirely containing this only, right? So therefore, this point is integer point of this. If I take here also, okay, the possibility is there. So that means we can draw one neighborhood of this point which is entirely containing this, and therefore these are all point integer point of this. Whereas coming to here, the smaller and smaller, okay, this is A, and of that, this is, I am taking that, the border point is A, this point is B if I take here. So inside value, what is the next number of, before, I don't know about the exact number, this A is not included in the set, before number, you can take that before number. So if I draw this number, there is possible to find that very smaller and smaller neighborhood which is entirely contained in the set. Therefore, the border element does not integer point of the set, but every point of before and after A is integer point of the set. Therefore, A is not integer point, B is not integer point. Before A and B are, between A and B are, all points are integer point of S. If I take here, so these are all not integer point of this set, right? So you can observe here, let S be a subset of R, a point P is said to be interior point of S if there exists at least one neighborhood of P which is entirely containing S. Then only say that so P is interior point of S. Okay, here if I take that here, they are unable to find at least one neighborhood which is not entirely contained in this set. That's why it is not integer point. You can take here, if I take this point, you are unable to find that which is not this neighborhood which is entirely contained in this set. Therefore, it is not integer point. Okay. So, this is the definition of interior points. Example. I'm taking that example S equal to 1, 2. Okay. If you understand this is logic, we can easily, okay, now we can understood what is the problem here. So this is real number. If you understand this logic, we'll easily understood all other problems. So, okay, I'm taking this is open 1 comma 2. Open interval 1 comma 2. What are the interior points of this set? So I am taking inside the points, so these are the points. The possibility, the open interval nothing but every point between this and this. Open interval nothing but every point between this here to here. Okay. These are all points. So, okay. So this, so between this point are all belonging to this set. You may write the other color here, you can use here. So these points are belonging to this set. Okay, this is first of all S. This set is S. What are the open interior points of this set? We want to find that interior point of this set. You can take any element between this and this. Okay, if I take here my entry point, the possibility is there exists at least one neighborhood for this point. This neighborhood enter contains this set. Thereby, this is entry point. You can take from here to here, every point is entry point of S. But if I take outside, so this point, this neighborhood, see, you can take any smaller and smaller neighborhood. So, okay, smaller and smaller neighborhood. This unable to find which is entirely contained. This we take big neighborhood also. So that means if I take this vigna, I put some of partial part is belong to this set, but which is does not entirely contain this set. That means if I take outside this set, which are not independent of this set. And the border also you can take that one. If I take one here, see if I take one, if I we can we will draw that one neighborhood of this side. Right hand part included in this, but left hand part is not included. That's why one is also not independent of this set. You can take two also. Same we can do. Okay, two also is not interpolated because if I draw one neighborhood for this right hand side does not included in this, so therefore two is also not interpolated of it. What are the interpolated of S? So, right? What are the interpolated of S? If I take here S, S is equal to open one comma two, right? Every point of S or interpolated of S. Every point of S or interpolated of S. If I take closed set, closed A comma B. So this is A, this is B. Okay. See every point between A and R interior point, but whereas coming to here, the border point here, this point, the border point here, this is B, A or not interior point. Why? Because if you draw a neighborhood for A, we'll get that left side part will some part will come. This part does not belong into S. This part does not belong to S. Therefore, A is not interpoint. B is also not interpoint. So A is not interpoint, B is not interpoint. Therefore, what are the interpoint of this S? S is equal to AB. That means interior point of S is equal to is open interval A comma B. Interior points of S equal to closed A comma B. Interior points are open A comma B. Why? Because the border element are not interior points of S. Okay, in place of A, you can take that. You may take that A comma B. So here one comma two only can be simply. So open one comma two. Interior point of S are open one comma two. Interior point of S are open one comma two. If I take this, right? So this is the interior point of S, right? Every point of S is an interior point of S. I already just now explained. But again, this is except one comma two. Every point between one and two are interior points of S. If I take S is equal to closed one two. Yeah. So what are the interior points of this set? What are the interior points of S? So you can understood here, right? This S, okay, this is real number. My S is what is S? If I take that S is equal to, what are the elements of S? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. S is equal to this. I'm taking this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What are the interior points of this set? That means interior point nothing but it only contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only, right? And you have to verify that. You can easily verify that. Interior point must be whether the belonging to this set or not. Okay, so we have to verify only 1, 2, 3, 5, whether this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are interior points or not. If I take that here, 1, I'm taking that. I want to draw a neighborhood for this. See, if I take neighborhood, we'll get 2 points. According to density property, what we'll get between any two real numbers, there exists infinite rational and irrational number. But S containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only. If I take that right side part, we'll get rational irrational numbers. So right hand side also will get rational irrational numbers. So that entirely does not containing S. Therefore, 1 is not interior point of S. Similarly, you can take that 2 is also not interior point. Why? Because if I draw one neighborhood for 2, Any abroad of 2 which is does not entirely contain S, therefore this also not interior point. You can take similar 3, 4, 5 also not interior points. Whereas if I take here the this point, I don't know about the point, the 3 point something else. If I draw a neighborhood for this, okay, that means this neighborhood contains a rational irrational part, thereby this set contains only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but this set contains a rational irrational part, so that means any part of rational irrational does not belong to this set, therefore. If I take between this number also or not interior point of this set, right? Interior point of S are empty set, does not have any interior points. S does not have interior point. Why? Because we are feeling that interior point, but at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are, interior, are looking that. That means definition is different, but S does not have any interior point. So similarly, I already explained this open interval A, B, interior point of S are open A, B. Similarly, you can say that open interval A, B are closed interval A, B, interior point of S are open A, B. S is equal to, you can take that semi intervals. If I take in semi intervals, so interior points of semi intervals are also open A, B. Here, if I take interior points of S or closed to A, open A, B, here the border element does not interior points, okay? So that's why open A, A. If I take S is equal to A, infinity, interior point of S also A, infinite. If I take S is equal to minus infinite A, interior point of S is minus infinite. That is my open intervals, right? If I take this set also, interior point of minus infinity A, or minus infinity A, if I take S is equal to 1 by N, N belongs to N. That means, if I take that N, so 1, this is 1, 1 by 2. One by four, right? 1/8. We are coming here. If you come to here, this end, the whatever and these are the smaller scope. Okay. So that means this set contains only rational numbers only. If I take neighborhood for n find, it contains irrational parts. That part does not belong to this set. Therefore, this set also does not have any interior point. So S also does not have any interior point. Why? Because rational numbers part does not include this set. Only rational numbers will get that. That means S does not have any interior point. Similarly, this set also does not have any interior points. N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, as right? Same already I explained about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The set similarly it is also same, right? If I take any point that this set contains only rational natural numbers, so but neighborhood contains rational and irrational parts, that means irrational part does not belong to this set, therefore N does not have any interior point. Similarly, W also not interior point, Z also not interior point. So Z does not have any interior point. What about Q? So Q is equal to P by Q, right? So now I am going to explain that Q so you can know that what are the elements of Q? So, elements of Q, this is a real line, okay. So, I want to draw that Q, numbers of Q are. Okay, these are the elements of, I'm writing that, the smaller and smaller, these are the elements of rational numbers. Whether I want to check that whether this point is interior point or not. I want to draw a neighborhood. For, I'm taking this point here. I want trying to draw a neighborhood for this point. So for this point, I'm drawing one neighborhood for, right? See, apparent definition of rational density property, every neighborhood of this point contains what element? Rational irrational number. Rational part belongs to Q, but irrational part does not belong to Q. If I take any real number, if I draw a neighborhood for this, in neighborhood, every neighborhood contains rational irrational numbers, but rational number belonging to Q, irrational number does not belong to Q. That means any neighborhood of any point in real number does not include it in this set. That's why, so Q also does not have any interior point. So Q also does not have any interior point. If I take R, so R nothing but right? So this real number, so why? Because if I take any real number, R is real number, you can take any number here, this is real number, P is, if I take S is equal to R only here, S is equal to R only. If I talk that, if I take, draw any neighborhood, why? Because if I take P point, every neighborhood is included R only, that means every point of R is an interior point of P. That means if you take any real number, if you draw any neighborhood, neighborhood can rational, irrational, nothing but real numbers, so every neighborhood of P contains real numbers only, that is included in R only, that was every point of R is an interior point of R, every point of R is an interior point of R. If I take S is equal to 1, 2, 3, union, 1, 2, union, 2, 3. Okay. So, see, closed A, what are the interior points of this open A, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2? What are the open interior points of 2, 3? Open 2, 3 only, right? So, every point of this set is an interior point of S. If I take that 1, 2, 3, 4. So, what are the interior points of this set 1, between 1 and 2? What are the interior points of 3 by 4, 3, 4? Every point of this set is interior point of that. That means every point of this set is interior point of S. Pi does not have any interior points. Pi does not have any interior point. So this is the about the interior points. Now I am going to discuss open set. Now I am going to discuss our topic, right? Let S be a subset of our list of A set, S is said to be open set if every point of S is an interior point of S. Be careful. A set, S is said to be, S is a set, a subset of R, whatever may be, a set, a subset of R is said to be open set if every point of S is an interior point of S. I'm taking that S is equal to open A comma B. Okay. So, now you can do that. So, I want to take that S is equal to open A comma B. This is a real line. Open A comma B. If I understand this, simply say that what are the interior points of this open interval? Every point of this set is open interval. Like A is not included, B is not included. Therefore, every point of this then interior point of this. Therefore, this open A comma B is an open set. If I take other set, so real number, if I take that open, sorry, if I take any closed, okay, so if I take that closed A comma B, this is A, this is B, this is S. So, every point of this is not included, but A comma B are not in interior point of this set. S include A comma B are not interior point of this set. Therefore, this set is not open set. What it means that every point of S is an open interior point of S, so then we say that it is open set, but the A comma B are not interior point of S, therefore, S is not open set. So similarly, you can observe all these things, right? Open A comma B, every point of S is an interior point of S, therefore S is an open set. If I take that closed A comma B, every point of S is an interior point of S, therefore S is an open set. If I take that N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, already I explained that this set does not have an interior point, therefore N is not interior point. W also does not have an interior point, W is also not open set. You can take observe here, Z also does not have any open interior point, therefore it does not open set. Q also does not have an interior point, therefore Q is also not open set. R, see, every point of R is interior point, therefore R is open set. If I take that, every point of this set is interior point. We already discussed now, this every point of this is interior point, therefore S is an open set. If I take S is equal to S, does not have any interior point, therefore it is not open set. Now what I am taking here, the elements of pi does not have any interior point, pi also does not have any point. So, does not interior point, does not have any, but if it is there, interior point is there. But, by construction, we are taking that pi is an open set. Pi is an open set. According to definition that this set does not have any interior points. So, pi also empty set. That means elements of this set and interior points are become same. That's why we are saying that pi is an open set. Every open interval is an open set, but converse need not be true. So every open interval is an open set, but converse need not be true. That means every open set need not be open interval. For suppose I am taking that 1 comma 2 union 2 comma 3. Already just now we discussed that this is open sets. 1 comma 2 union 2 comma 3 are open set. But if I comes to here, interval nothing but between 1, 2, 3, every point is belonging to this interval, this set only. But 2 does not belong to this set. Therefore, this is not interval. Interval nothing but there is no break. So 1, 2, 3, continuously all elements belong to this set only. But if I come to here, so there is break coming. That's why 2 does not belong to this. Therefore, it is not interval. So every interval is open set, but every open set need not be interval. Union of open set is an open set. This is open set, this is open set, union is also open set. Intersection of two open set is an open set. If I take that intersection 1, 2, intersection 2, comma 3, intersection is pi. So intersection 1, comma 2 is also 1, comma 2. So this is open set, this is open set, this is also open set. If I take pi intersection r equal to pi, so the pi is open set, therefore it is also open set. Union of finite number of open set is an open set. Union of finite number of open set is an finite number. So we can observe here 1 comma union, 2 comma 3 union, like that, 1 comma 100. If I take that, 1 comma 11, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 3, 3 comma 1 comma 3, union 10 comma 10. So I am observing that this is union equal 1 comma 10. So that means union of finite open sets is also open set. Intersection of finite open sets. Intersection of finite number of open sets is an open set. If I take intersection of all finite open sets, if I do intersection, then what happens? Intersection must be included, but all intersection is implicate finite. That means intersection of finite number of open set is an open set. Union of infinite family of open set is an open set. Union of infinite family of open set is an open set. If I take this 4 comma 6 as yes, that equal, right? As entered in infinite, what will be 5 minus 1, 5 minus 1 that equal 4. So it goes to union, then what happened? 4 comma 6. N equal to 1, you can substitute here 4 comma 6. All other intervals are less than this interval only. If I do union, then what will get here 4 comma 6 only get. That means this union equal to 4 comma 6, this open set is also interval as I have open set. Intersection of infinite family of open set is need not be open set. Intersection of infinite family of open set is not open set. If I do intersection, then what happened? 2 comma infinity, 2 minus n, 2 comma plus 1 by n. So intersection 2, what happened? 2 minus 1, 1 comma 3, 4 comma 3. So like that, we will get all these things. So 2, n tends infinity, then what happened? 2, singleton 2. Intersection, what will happen? We will get finest, singleton 2 only. That equal to singleton 2 only. Singleton 2 is finite set. Finite set, every finite set is not open set. It is not open set. Therefore, it is also not open set. See, if I observe this thing, if I do intersection, finally we will get singleton 2 only. Singleton 2 only, right? It is look like 2 plus 1 by n. So, the set is look like that 1 comma 3. So, 1 comma so this is 0, this is 2, so sorry, so between point I will get right, I will write here 2 only, 1, 2, 3. So if I do intersection, intersection of all this is bigger intersection. If I do all these things, the finitely you will get that intersection concluded only 2 only, that equal to 2 only. Singleton 2 is finite set is open set, not open set. Therefore, this is not open set. So now, coming to the point closer set. Let a subset of R, a set S is said to be, let a subset of R and a set to S is said to be closed set. If the complement of S or S complement is equal to R minus S is an open set. A set is said to be open set, closed set, if S complement is open. A subset of R is said to be closed set if D of S is subset of R. Other thing, S complement open set or
डी ऑफ एस इज सबसेट ऑफ एस, सबसेट ऑफ एस इज सेट टू बी ओवरऑल सेट इफ डी ऑफ एस इज सबसेट ऑफ एस। ये टू डेफिनेशन यू कैन यूज फॉर फाइंडिंग दैट। ओके सो here I'm taking that s is equal to d of s equal to 1 by 2, 1 comma 2. Okay, both are same, right? S is closed, that means d of s equal to s only. Therefore, s is d of subset of s, therefore s is closed. Again, I want to use that s dash is equal to what happened? S is equal to closed. S dash is equal to r minus that equal to. So this is r, this is s, s is equal to 1 comma 2. I want to remove from this. I want to remove from. We will get that minus infinite 1 union 2 comma infinite 1. So this is S dash. Already we discussed that these are the open set. This is also open set. Already we know that union of two open set is open. This is open, this is open, this is also open. That means S complement is open, therefore S is closed. So this is one way. Can use that D of S is the very easy. Okay, D of S is subset of S, so it is very easy. But some case we can use this also. According to definition, it is not open set, therefore S is closed set. S is equal to A closed A comma B. DF is equal to A comma B subset of, that means S is closed A set. Same, S is equal to 1, open 1 comma 2. DF is equal to what happened 1 comma 2. 1 comma 2 does not subset of S. Why? Because it has other element 1 comma 2. Therefore, S is not closed set. S is equal to open A comma B. DF is equal to closed A comma B subset of S. So S is not closed set. Okay, this open comma 2 in place of 1 comma 2, I'm writing A comma. Note, every closed interval is closed set. Every closed interval is closed set. Corners of above statement need not be true. Why? Because every closed set need not be closed interval. Suppose if I take S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what is the DF S? D of s is equal to pi. That means s does not have any integer. Because okay, now D of s is equal to limit points. What are the limit points of s? Pi. Pi subset of s. By our definition, D of s subset of s, then s is called closed set. Therefore, s is closed set. But it is not closed interval. Why? Because internal, but every point between 1 comma 5 belongs to S. See, between 1 comma 2 any number does not belong to S. Between 2 comma 3 any number does not belong to S. Therefore, it consists of rational irrational number does not belong to S. Therefore, it is not interval. Can you observe here? This is interval 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4, between this number, it's how can you say that? Does not belong in S. Therefore, it is not closed to interval. I can use other definition. S dash is equal to what we know that S dash nothing but S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. By S dash is equal to what happened? This S. So, S dash nothing but I want to remove from this 1, 2, 3, 5. So I am removing this. Final, what we will get here? From here to here, right to right set here minus infinite 1, union 1, comma 2, union 2, comma 3, union 3, comma 4, union 4, comma 5. From here to here, right here, pi comma infinite, right? This is open, this is open, this is open, this is open, this is open. Already we know that union of two open interval, union of finite number of open sets are open set. That means this is open set. S dash open set, then this is closed. Similarly, you can apply n equal to, admit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, missing here, up to so on. The n is natural number set is also not open set. It is closed set simply. D of n equal to what even pi, subset r equal to n, therefore n is closed set. Similarly, we can use same criteria, same definition. India is open, therefore n is closed. India is open, therefore n is closed. W, d of w equal to how much? Pi. Pi subset of w. There, pi is not, pi is an, sorry, w is an closed set. Get z. D of d equal to how much? Pi. So, s is closed set. Q, d of q equal to how much? R. R is not subset of pi. Sorry, q. R is not subset of q. Therefore, q is not closed set. Sorry, get d of q equal to r does not subset of q, therefore q is not closed set. Q is not here, not missing. Q is not a closed set. You can take r, d of r equal to r, r subset r equal to r. We already know that r is closed set. You can phi, d of phi equal to how much? Phi, phi subset of phi. So phi is closed set. So that means already we know that pi is closed set, you can say pi is closed and r is closed, n double theta are closed and q does not close. So you can observe here clearly. Note, union of two closed set is closed set. You can do 1, 2, union, 3, 4, df is equal to this, s is closed set. If you take this is closed set, this is also n union w equal to w, w is also closed set, therefore this is also closed set. 1 comma 2 intersection 3 comma 4, okay, not required here. Intersection of any two closed set is closed. Intersection if I do in this way, 1 comma 2 union intersection 3 comma 4 that equal to pi, pi is closed set. Df is equal to 1 comma 2 union 3 comma 4. So df is equal to how much, so this is the only set, right, which is subset of s. But because my s is this set only, if both are equal, therefore s is closed set. N intersection w is equal to n, so therefore n is closed, therefore this is also closed. Union of finite number of family of closed set is not closed set. Why? Because finite number is closed set. 1 comma 2 union 3 comma 4 1 comma, right? If I do union, then we will get 100, 1 comma 100, therefore s is closed set. Q union, N union, W union, Z union, Q union, R. That equal to R. R is closed set. Therefore, union of finite number of is also closed set. Intersection of finite number of family of closed set is also closed. See, observe that intersection into phi, pi is closed set. Therefore, this set is also closed to set. S is closed set, right? Every finite set is closed set. Every finite set is closed set. Intersection of infinite family of closed sets is closed set. Intersection of infinite family of closed set is closed, right? You can do here one comma intersection. If I do intersection, what will get here? Singleton one, singleton. You already know that every finite set is closed set. S is also closed set. S is one equal to, observe here, 0 comma 2, s2 equal to 1 by 2 comma 4. That means finally what we have here, 0 comma 0 to 1, all numbers go to intersection. If I do that, only we will get 1. Intersection will get singleton. Okay. So, union of infinite family of closed set is not closed set. Union of infinite family of closed set is not closed set. So, not closed set, here, observe here, here this something is missing, union of this equal to, so, union of n equal to 1 to infinite 1 minus finite closed set, closed set, union of finite number of closed sets, right? Okay, union, right? Closed set is nothing but closed. Sorry, 1 plus so what happened? N equal to substitute 1, then what happened? N equal to 1 substitute to 0 to substitute n equal to, then what happened? 3 by 2 n equal to 3 to 3 by 2 5 by 2. If I do all union, this is bigger set, and that means, so if I take here, this is real n. So n equal to, if I take here, what is the union, first n equal to 0, so 0. 0, 2. So next set is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is nothing but where is 3 by 2? 1.5. Here maybe it will look like this. 1.5. Sorry, if we get n equal to 2 minus 1 by 1 by 2, sorry. Not here. This is 1 by 2. This is 1 by 2. If 1 is there here, this is the this interval. If you do all these things, this next you will got to off of this. So set of all letters and what will get here? Union, sir. Set of all union will get all these 0 comma 2. Therefore, so you can that union of infinite family of closed set is also closed set. This is closed set. Closer. Let S subset of R, then S union D of S is called closure of S. It is denoted by S bar. S bar equal to S union D of S. S equal to that, D of S equal to pi. S bar equal to S union D of S, that equal to S. That means, this is called closure. Closure of N. N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, data, so D of N equal to pi. N bar equal to N union D of N, that equal to N. You can take W equal to, you can take that, W bar equal to W. Z equal to take that, Z bar equal to A. That means, Z union equal to Z union D of S, Z equal to pi. Z union D of Z union pi equal to Z. If I K D of Q equal to Q, Z bar D of pi equal to Q, Q bar equal to what happened? Sorry, you are missing Q bar here. So here Q bar is equal to Q union D of P, that equal to Q. R bar D of bar equal to pi, so then R bar equal to R union D of R, that equal to R. If I take S is equal to open A comma B, D of S equal to closed A comma B, S union equal to S union D of S, that equal to closed A comma B. If I take S is equal to closed A comma B, closed A comma B, D of S equal to closed A comma B, S bar equal to union S union D of S, that equal to closed A comma B. S is equal to symmetric, you can take that, S bar equal to closed A comma B, you will get. Okay. So, these are the closure of any set. Dense set. A subset of B is said to be dense in B if A bar is equal to B. A subset of B is said to be dense in B if A bar is equal to B. I am taking that S is equal to open A comma B. This is A. This is B. Closed A comma B is equal to. So S bar equal to what happened? Here S bar equal to nothing but closed A comma B. Closed A nothing but B only. Therefore, S is dense in closed A comma B. Q bar. Q bar is equal to already, you know that Q bar is equal to R and Q subset of R. Therefore, Q is dense in R. So, these are the examples of dense sets. So, S open interval A comma B is dense in closed interval A comma B. Q is dense in open A comma R. Sorry, Q is dense in R. Okay. So, enumerable set. A set. A subset of R is said to be enumerable set if there exists bijection map F S to N. Okay, a set S is said to be a subset of R is said to be enumerable set if there exists bijection map F S to N. Example, you could say that N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, F N to N. F of x equal to x, you can take that, right? So, suppose to I want to draw here how there is a bijection map between S2. Already you know that bijection map number 2, it is 1 1 and R2. Okay. So, I want to show that N is enumerable. Here this is N. So 1, 2, 3 like this. 1, 2, 3. Bayesian nothing but what? Distinct element have distinct images, and every element of the codomain has three image. So 1, 1 and 1, 2 it is nothing but. So, if I draw a graph like this, I want to draw a graph like this. So, 1 goes to 1, 2 goes to 2, 3 goes to 3. So, so like this. So, how do we draw here? F of x over map is, I am writing here for this. F of x equal to x, right? So, you can have the distinct element of distinct images and every element have pre-image. 1 has pre-image 1, 2 has pre-image 2, 3 has 3, right? So that means it is 1 1 and n 2. That means there exists bijection map between n to n. So therefore we say that n is enumerable set. If I take w, w also enumerable set. W also enumerable set. Okay. If I take that w, there exists bijection map between w to n, right? If I take 0, f of x could express one. Map my map is same w n. How can we define map here? G express w. By substitute x equal to 0, then what happened? 1. 1 goes to 2, 0 goes to 1, 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 4, right? So that means every element have pre-image. Every element has pre-image. And distinct element have distinct image. Therefore, there exists bijection map between w to n. There exists bijection map between w to n. So therefore, w is also enumerable set. Z. So z is also enumerable. How can I take in here? So 1 goes to 0 goes to 1, 1 goes to minus 1 goes to 2, 1 goes to 3, minus 2 goes to 4, 2 goes to 5, minus 3 goes to like this. So elements. So my map is defined like this. How I can define is 1 minus 2x if x is less than or equal to 0, 2x if x is less than 0. This is the map. And define here, f of 0 equal to 1, f of 1 equal to 2, f of minus 3, 2, 4, 5, like this, define, apply here. So, this is my distinct element of distinct images, so, and every element of pre-image. So, therefore, here that z to n is bijection map. We are thinking that it has some infinite elements and extra element, n is subset of w, how to find this infinite set, that's why I am able to find. You are unable to say that. There does not exist any bijection map. So that, but so this is the way you can choose the bijection map. So therefore, Z is enumerable set. Z is enumerable, right? S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. F, S2, N does not exist any bijection map. If S not, why? Because if I take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it has infinite. 1 goes to 1, 2 goes to 2, 3 goes to 3, 4 goes to 4, 5, right? But here, if I take that 1, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, does not have any pre image. Therefore, they are unable to find any bijection map between S to N. Therefore, S is not enumerable set, right? Q is also enumerable set. If I take that, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, right? 1 goes to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 goes to 2, 1 by 3 by 3. Like that, 1 by 3 goes to 3, like that, you can choose that. So, see, this way, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6, right? Next, you can take that other element, 2, 2, 2, 3, right? So, in this way, we can choose that the possibility is there. Okay, so Q is enumerable set. You can there is a possibility there for finding any bijection map between the, how can, 1 goes to 1, 1 by 2 goes to 2, 3 by 4 goes to 3, 3 1 by 3 goes to 3, like that you can choose map. We are unable to find bijection mapping, therefore Q is enumerable set. R is not enumerable set because we are unable to find any bijection map between that. Why? Because if I take S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so R, you can take that S is equal to, you can take that of R, R is equal to 1, immediate number, right? You can choose here. So if I take this set, so 1, 2, 3, like this, okay? R. Here 1, 2, 3, right? What is the next number unable to find? 1 goes to 1. What is the next number unable to say? What is the next number? This number unable to say that does not containing any map. So between this number, right? So I feel that there are unable to find any bijection map. That's why R is not enumerable set. So this is also S is equal to is not also enumerable set. Why? Because next number we are unable to say that. It is not enumerable set. Countable set. Let S a set, S is set to subset of R is said to be countable set if first one is S is equal to empty set, second one is S is finite set, third one is S is enumerable set. Otherwise, the set S is called uncountable set. So, I'm calling that a set SE set to service power is set to be countable set if SE is finite empty set, SE is finite set as SE is enumerable set. Already we know that pi is empty set, pi is countable. SE is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, SE is finite set. Already we discussed about the finite set. Therefore, SE is countable. If I take N is countable, so already N is enumerable. W is countable, because W is enumerable. Already just we discussed. Z is countable, so why? Because enumerable. R is, Q is also countable. Why? Because Q is enumerable. Already just now discussed. R is uncountable. Why? Because R is unable to find count, unable to count the next number. In Q we are able to find the 1/2, 1/3 like this. But R next number unable to find, right? But like any open interval like can be open like can be that or not countable set. You can take that A B close like can be. That means in this set if I take here any number open, right? Here suppose if I take 1, 2, close 1, 2. So what is the next number? We are, if 1 is my first number, next number is unable to say that. What is the next number? How can we choose the next number? So that is very difficult to find the number. That's why this set also open a combi, close a combi. This open interval and close intervals are all rays or open infinite open intervals are not countable sets, right? Uncountable sets. These are uncountable. R and subset of this onion intervals of R are uncountable sets, right? Mathematical induction principle, right? So already this all this we know about this, but just now I want to mention the this mathematical induction. Okay. So the following statement belonging to natural number is called mathematical induction, right? If it is true for p of 1 or it is true for n equal to 1, it is true for p of m, it is true for n equal to m, it is true for p of m or it is, then we say that if it is true for p of m plus 1 or if it is true for n equal to m plus 1, then it is true for all p of n when n equal to m. So that means this is belonging to natural numbers. Okay, first of all we are checking that this is statement for natural numbers. First of all it is true for n equal to 1, next n equal to m. Then it is true for n equal to m plus 1, then the statement is true for all n equal to m plus 1, right? So this is the basis of real analysis is completed, lecture 9. So thank you for watching this by Dr. P. Ramlu. Okay. So thank you for watching this. Have a nice day. Thank you.